Mass this morning at 11:30. We will start in about 10 minutes. I'm using a new program to broadcast, so hopefully everything will go well. If not, just let me know after Mass. Okay, so the sound should be good enough. And and also the picture should be fine. So please prepare. You will be able to, you should be able to send over prayers of intercessions through the Facebook, through the YouTube site of this video. So if you click on the video window on the parish website or on Facebook, you will be redirected to YouTube, and there you should be able to send from there. You should be able to send bidding prayers. Okay, I'm just going to check things if they are set up properly on Facebook as well. Great. Okay, so forgot to put the hymns on the Facebook, at the parish website, but let's see what we can do now. And pictures, here we are. I'm just going to leave it as it is. So you will find the Mass on the parish website at St. Peter's Aberdeen, stpetersaberdeen.com. Let's begin our celebration singing Alleluia, Sing to Jesus. And I'm going to put it into the stream.
Thank you.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all, and with your spirit. Dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison. Christe eleison, Christe eleison. Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living Father, constantly accomplish the Paschal mystery within us,
that those you were pleased to make new in holy baptism may, under your protective care, bear much fruit and come to the joys of life eternal. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. About this time, when the number of disciples was increasing, the Hellenists made a complaint against the Hebrews. In the daily distribution, their only widows were being overlooked. So the 12 called a full meeting of the disciples and addressed them. It would not be right for us to neglect the word of God so as to give out food. You, brothers, must select from yourselves 7 men of good reputation, filled with the Spirit and with wisdom. We will hand over this duty to them and continue to devote ourselves to prayer and to the service of the word. The whole assembly approved of this proposal and elected Stephen, a man full of faith and of the Holy Spirit, together with Philip, Prochorus, Nicanor, Timon, Parmenas, and Nicholas of Antioch, a convert to Judaism. They presented these to the apostles, who prayed and laid their hands on them. The word of the Lord continued to spread. The number of disciples in Jerusalem was greatly increased, and a large group of priests made their submissions to the faith. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
May your love be upon us, O Lord, as we place all our hope in you.
May your love be upon us, O Lord, as we place all our hope in you.
Ring out your joy to the Lord, O you just, for praise is fitting for loyal hearts. Give thanks to the Lord upon the harp. With a 10-stringed lute, sing him songs. May your love be upon us, O Lord, as we place all our hope in you. For the word of the Lord is faithful, and all his works to be trusted. The Lord loves justice and right, and fills the earth with his love. May your love be upon us, O Lord, as we place all our hope in you. The Lord looks on those who revere him, on those who hope in his love, to rescue their souls from death, to keep them alive in famine. May your love be upon us, O Lord, as we place all our hope in you. A reading from the first letter of St. Peter. The Lord is the living stone, rejected by men, but chosen by God and precious to him. Set yourselves close to him so that you too, the holy priesthood that offers the spiritual sacrifices which Jesus Christ has made acceptable to God, may be living stones, making a spiritual house. As Scripture says, "See how I lay in Zion a precious cornerstone that I have chosen, and the man who rests his trust on it will not be disappointed." That means that for you who are believers, it is precious. But for unbelievers, the stone rejected by the builders has proved to be the keystone, a stone to stumble over, a rock to bring men down. They stumble over it because they do not believe in the word. It was the fate in store for them. But you are a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a consecrated nation, a people set apart to sing the praises of God who called you out of the darkness into his wonderful light. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Alleluia. Jesus said, I am the way to truth and the life. No one can come to the Father except through me. Alleluia. 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 The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus said to his disciples, do not let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God still and trust in me. There are many rooms in my Father's house. If there were not, I should have told you. I am now going to prepare a place for you. And after I have gone and prepared you a place, I shall return to take you with me, so that where I am, you may be too. You know the way to the place where I am going. Thomas said, Lord, we do not know where you are going, so how can we know the way? Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father except through me. If you know me, you know my Father too. From this moment, you know him and have seen him. Philip said, Lord, let us see the Father, and then we shall be satisfied. Have I been with you all this time, Philip, said Jesus to him, and you still do not know me? To have seen me is to have seen the Father. So how can you say, let us see the Father? Do you not believe that I am in the Father, and the Father is in me? The words I say to you, I do not speak as from myself. It is the Father, living in me, who is doing this work. You must believe me when I say that I am in the Father, and the Father is in me. Believe it on the evidence of this work, if for no other reason. I tell you most solemnly, whoever lives, believes in me, will perform the same works as I do myself. He will perform even greater works, because I am going to the Father. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. In the first reading, what really caught my attention was how important was the spreading of the Word of God for the apostles. So how important the Word itself is. The spreading of the Word particularly enjoyed a very first priority in their ministry. Now, I know this from, you can see this from the first reading. Once the apostles hear about the complaints of the Hellenists, that the widows are neglected actually by the apostles, then they quickly make a new arrangement. And they ask the disciples to choose seven people from among them, so that they can keep focusing on the spreading of the message of the Word of God. So this is how important the Word of God is. The spreading of the message of God was not for the interest of the apostles, but it was for the sake of the people themselves. Because what happened, we just celebrated not so long ago, Jesus' death and resurrection. Now, these people were told lies by their leaders, by the thieves and the brigands, and Jesus refers to them in last Sunday's gospel as such. They stole their hearts because they were telling them they were demand Jesus' crucifixion. Despite that these people have seen what Jesus has done, and the wonderful things he has done. But unfortunately, their leaders, they abuse their powers, and then they tell them lies, and so they steal their hearts, not just because of that, but because they also listen to them. They don't listen to their hearts, where God spoke to them. They didn't listen to the voice of the Good Shepherd,
but they listen to the voice of the thieves. So this is how things work, unfortunately. Even if you see the miracles of Jesus, if someone has greater power over you, and you listen to that voice and not the voice of the Good Shepherd, then you will inevitably, your heart will be robbed. Your heart will be stolen. So this is now the time when we come to this reading, when Peter preaches that these people have to be told the truth about Jesus's who he is. And so now the disciples, the apostles themselves, focus on the voice of the Good Shepherd. They know they have to be the voice of the Good Shepherd, so they tell them the truth, and they win them back to God. And if that's not enough, they say that you only have to repent and that you will receive forgiveness. And if that's not enough, you will even receive eternal happiness. So this is why these people are so excited and are baptized. 3,000 are baptized. The thief is away. Now the Good Shepherd is here. And the Good Shepherd wins back the heart of the people through his voice, through the apostles who transmit, who live stream or broadcast the voice of the Good Shepherd. So this is what's going on in the background. So it's very important. Now, this is quite relevant to us as well, because we also hear the teaching of Jesus. We also have witnessed probably his miracles or his healing power in our lives. But we are also bombarded with the voice of the thieves, of secularism, of materialism, and all these things. But at the same time, the Good Shepherd is also speaking to us. So we need to choose almost every day whose voice we listen to. But the problem is, how do you distinguish between the voice of the Good Shepherd and the voice of the thieves and brigands? Now, first of all, it's very important that we start reading the Bible, okay? Because we have to have a general picture about who Jesus is, who the Good Shepherd is, and what is his way of thinking, what are his principles of life. But the Bible only gives you a general picture. It doesn't give you the living voice, the live broadcast of the voice of the Good Shepherd. We need to actually learn to hear through the scriptures the voice of the Good Shepherd. Lectio Divina is always mentioned. I like to mention it because Lectio Divina uses the Bible. So basically, first you have to pray to the Holy Spirit to fill your mind and heart, and also to bring the words of the scriptures alive, certain words through which the Father and the Son wants to speak to you. And so you pray first to the Holy Spirit, then read the Bible in Lectio Divina, and then you listen, try to see which word or phrase comes alive, which word or phrase is different from the rest of it, which one touches your heart, perhaps. And then you ask God to tell you, why is this word different? Why is this word touching your heart? And you kind of listen, you will definitely hear something, some voice, some thoughts will come into your minds, and just trust them. Don't worry about whether this comes from you or from God himself, because eventually you will get the message of God. That's why the Holy Spirit is there. But you can experience, so this way you can hear the voice of the Good Shepherd. But in daily life, when you don't have the Bible with you, you can also hear the voice of God and message of God through other people, like through your spouse, through your brother or sister, through nature, even through the television, through radio as well, provided that you want to hear the voice of the shepherd. He doesn't just shout at you and then you will hear it. No, we have to be attentive every day and seek to hear God's voice.
Otherwise, you won't be able to hear it, especially when you are bombarded with other messages and images as well. I will give you finally just a few principles also that helps you to distinguish between the voice of the Good Shepherd and the voice of the thieves. For example, God's voice leaves your heart with peace. If you hear something, something comes to your mind, if it's from God, it will leave peace in your in yourself, a deep sense of peace, whereas Satan always tries to leave a disturbance in your heart and mind. Also, God's voice never pushes you to do things because he respects your freedom always. Whereas Satan's voice seduces you to do actions, then it arouses passions or desires, so much so that you lose your freedom to do what is right, what you believe is the right thing to do. Now, also God never flatters you with kind, nice words, so that you do what he wants you to do, and then he leaves you behind when you are of no use. That's the way of evil. No, God always tells you the truth, whether it is difficult to hear or not. He admonishes when you commit a sin, and then he encourages you and consoles you. He doesn't accuse you. God's voice also opens up a wider horizon for you when you do a planning, because he wants you to take into account the wider horizon of life, especially your eternal destiny, whereas evil wants you to focus on the here and now, always just to be worried about the here and now, or about the past hurts, to dwell on the past hurts, or to always just to disturb you in some way. So God opens up the wider horizon. God is always in the present. He speaks to you in the present. He wants you to focus on the present as well when it comes to worries. And he wants you to know that he's present with you. So there's nothing to worry about. He keeps everything in his hand. Whereas evil, again, he wants you to focus on the past hurts and also to dwell on it, to discourage you to from loving people, especially those who have hurt you. God always dares you to think about what is for your spiritual benefit, what is for the spiritual benefit of others, whereas evil wants you to focus on what is materially good for you, what is important for you, or maybe materially good for other people, but never on what is good for you spiritually. And finally, God always puts words of life and light into our minds and hearts. He wants you to fill your minds and hearts with the things of heaven, whereas evil wants you to focus on your ego, on your material needs, and so on. So I will put this homily on the website so you will be able to actually see all these principles and look through it and memorize it. So when it comes to trying to discern or distinguish between different voices, then you will have it already there.
Let us now profess our faith.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried.
He descended into heaven.
On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there, he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Let us now pray to the Father who holds us back to him.
We pray for the Church, in particular for those of our brothers and sisters who are suffering for their faith. May the Holy Spirit give them courage and strengthen their faith. Lord, in your goodness,
hear our prayer.
We pray for politicians that they may not just listen to the words of Pope Francis, but also act upon it. Lord, in your goodness,
hear our prayer.
We pray for ourselves that we may become like Christ, who shows everyone the way to the Father's house. Lord, in your goodness,
hear our prayer.
We pray for the intention of Pope Francis that Mary, the star of evangelists, may guide the Church as she teaches about Christ to all nations. Lord, in your goodness,
hear our prayer.
We pray for those who are suffering any kind of illness. May they experience God's closeness to them and accept their cross of pain as Jesus did. Lord, in your goodness,
hear
our prayer.
You're encouraged to send your prayer intentions and just now, and I will read them up. If you are watching this video, you can go to the YouTube site of the video, and there you can send messages. Let us pray for unity in families where there is division, and for unity of our diverse community. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. You can also send messages to my WhatsApp, if you know my mobile number, and I will read it up from there. Or if you want to send a text message, you are welcome to do so. Let us also pray for Edgar's father. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Also, please pray for, Edgar's father, who has been hospitalized and is unconscious at the moment. Let us pray for his recovery, and also for all the sick in our parish and those who are suffering from this virus or other kind of illnesses. And also pray for wisdom and good skills for their doctors and nurses and carers. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Let us pray for all those who have given their lives so that we can be safe today, especially for soldiers and other people, nurses and doctors, as we celebrated the Victory Day this week, or last week, I mean. Let us pray for the eternal repose of their souls. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
And in this month of May, which is dedicated to our love for Mary, let us pray also for her intercession. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Loving Father, give us strength for our earthly spiritual journey and protect us from all evil. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. And for the offertory, we are going to sing the holy words. I'm going to project it on the screen, so you should be able to see it in a few seconds.
Let the ancient words impart. Ancient words. changing me and changing you. We have come with broken hearts. Oh, let the ancient words begin. Ancient words never true. Changing me and changing you. We have come with broken hearts.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy Church. O God, who by the wonderful exchange effected in this sacrifice have made us partakers of the one supreme Godhead, grant, we pray, that as we have come to know your truth, we may make it ours by a worthy way of life. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you, and with your spirit. Lift up your hearts, we lift them up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and just. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to lord you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. By the oblation of his body, he brought the sacrifices of all to fulfillment in the reality of the cross, and by commending himself to you for our salvation, showed himself the priest, the altar, and the lamb of sacrifice. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts him your praise. And even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Father, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Mystery of faith, save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Father, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and you, our bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her beloved spouse, with the blessed apostles, Peter, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Now let us say together the act of spiritual communion. You will find the text on the parish website at stpetersaberdeen.com. So it's stpetersaberdeen.com. Let us pray. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. And now let us sing together the communion hymn, which is Come and Praise Him Again. Well, this is only available on the Facebook page of the parish, just to make things complicated. So it's on the Facebook page. You will find it in the comments section. It may not display, but if you go to the comments section, it should be there.
Come and praise him, royal priesthood. Come and worship, holy nation. Worship Jesus, our Redeemer. He is risen, King of glory. Come and praise him, royal priesthood. Come and praise him, holy nation. Worship Jesus, our Redeemer. He is risen, King of glory. Come and praise him, royal priesthood. Come and worship, holy nation. Worship Jesus, our Redeemer. He is risen, King of glory.
Let us pray.
Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated for a few moments. Just for the announcements, on Monday, after the evening Mass, which is 6 p.m., there is a catechism for adults at 7 p.m. And on Wednesday and Friday, at 7:30 p.m., I will continue the talks, but these will be shorter, the talks, than the usual ones. So these will be about half an hour, and they will be on the topic of renewal. Okay. Also, I will send out the bulletin very soon. There is a message from the Vatican, the Higher Commission for Fraternity, something like this is called, the Higher Commission or Committee for Fraternity, requests that we have a global day of fasting on the 14th of May, Thursday, for the whole day, and also to pray for those who are affected by the pandemic, but especially for the end of the pandemic, and also for the intercession of Our Lady, and also pray for the renewal of humanity. So when this is over, then we will not go back to our old ways, but we will start in a new way. So let this be an opportunity for renewal, reviewing your priorities and building your life on the cornerstone, Jesus Christ. So that's on the 14th of May. Skiaf also sent out a message. If you want to have your donation doubled by the UK government, or kind of matched by the UK government, then if you could please send your donations to Skiaf directly by the 20th of May. I know I put into the bulletins, I put a different message in the past, but now I have changed it because Skiaf just sent out a message this week that the deadline for the UK government match is actually the 20th of May. So I think that's all for just now. Please stand for the final blessing. Oh yes, one more thing, sorry, I forgot. There was a bidding prayer which came a bit late. And this is a request to pray for all families and friends
who are far away from the Lord, for their return back to the Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you all, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. Let's now sing our difficult song, which is a beautiful, well, the lyrics are very good, but it's difficult to sing. God's Spirit is in my heart. God's Spirit is in my heart. I hope there will be a new melody for this song, because it's quite crazy, jumping through two different octaves. Again, you can check the parish Facebook for the song. And my apologies, I forgot to put it on the parish website. So you have to go to the parish Facebook, or see, if you go to the 9:30 Mass link on the parish Facebook of St. Peter's, there you will find all the songs in the comments section. So this one is, I think it's him. Which one is it? 183 on Facebook, not in our book, it's different. God's Spirit is in my heart. He has called me and set me apart. This is what I have to do, what I have to do. He sent me to give the good news to the poor. Tell prisoners that they are prisoners no more. Tell blind people that they can see. And set the downtrodden free. And go tell everyone the news that the kingdom of God has come. And go tell everyone the news that God's kingdom has come. Just as the Father sent me, so I'm sending you out to be my witnesses throughout the world, the whole of the world. He sent me to give the good news to the poor, the prisoners, that they are prisoners no more, the blind people that they can see, and set the downtrodden free, and go tell everyone the news that the kingdom of God has come. And go tell everyone the news that God's kingdom has come. So take care, everybody, and hope to see me on Monday tomorrow for the evening Mass or some other time.